Iraqi army troops continue to close in on taking back control of Mosul from ISIS militants who captured it 3 years ago. Mosul was the country's second largest city after Baghdad. One U.S. commander says U.S. Army forces are helping the Iraqis in a, quote, very close fight in the streets of Mosul. Many of the tens of thousands of civilians trapped by the fighting with little food or water are now trying to flee to safety. Reuters reporter Stephen Kalin is covering the conflict and joins me now via Skype from the Iraqi city of Irbil, about 60 miles east of Mosul. On Thursday, the Iraqi prime minister said basically victory has been declared over the caliphate. You were just there in Mosul yesterday. What's it look like?
Fighting is ongoing in the old city of Mosul, which is a centuries-old district of the city. I mean, this is the last area of Mosul that Islamic State still has some presence in. It's going to be pretty grim, really narrow alleyways and, fighting that gets very close combat.
Tell me about the civilians that you saw there, the ones that were fleeing.
Yeah, we were at the site of the Grand Mosque in the heart of the old city, which is where Islamic State leader Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi made his appearance 3 years ago. And this is where we saw civilians streaming out. It was a few dozens that we saw, but I later heard that it was actually a few thousand overall yesterday that left the old city. And they were coming out in very desperate state. I've seen thousands and thousands of residents fleeing Mosul over the past 8 months, and these were by far the worst, in the worst condition.
Why did they stay there as long as they did? I mean, were some of them being held against their will as human shields?
Islamic State has been using civilians as human shields this entire time, for this entire battle, because they know that the Iraqi forces, and especially the international coalition backing them, is doing everything they can to prevent civilian casualties. So they'll often force civilians to stay in the lower grounds of the building and then post a sniper on top so that sniper is in some ways protected from mortar attacks or airstrikes.
Tell us a little bit about this mosque and why it's such an important symbol there.
The Grand Nuri Mosque is at the center of the old city, and it has a minaret which is 840 years old, which is leaning sort of like the Leaning Tower of Pisa. Due to, we think, structural problems. It began leading very soon after its construction. So this is an iconic site in Mosul. It is also where Islamic State leader Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi came in July 2014, made his really the only public appearance that we know of, a confirmed public appearance, and proclaimed himself the caliph, the leader of the Islamic State. This is the place where he came, and Iraqi forces were hoping to get to this site, take down the black ISIS flag that has been hanging there for the past 3 years, and string up the tricolor Iraqi flag as a really symbolic sign of victory. They weren't able to do that because just over a week ago, Islamic State rigged the entire complex with explosives and blew it up. The only part of the mosque that was still intact was the dome under which Baghdadi stood and made that message 3 years ago.
You know, the Iraqi forces that you speak to, what's the next step? Let's say, best case scenario, they retake the city. It's in ruins right now.
That's right. The infrastructure in Mosul is very heavily damaged. Where there is electricity and water, it's usually provided by generators or water trucks that are shipping this in, so that the basic infrastructure is not there. So the battle continues, and security and stability, maintaining that really is going to be a trick for the security forces as well. We're almost 100% sure that Islamic State has left sleeper cells, that some of their fighters have blended in with the civilian population. And so we expect that, you know, there will be some sort of a return to insurgent attacks. And that'll be task number one for the security forces to handle.
All right, Stephen Kalin of Reuters joining us via Skype from Erbil tonight. Thanks so much.
Thanks for having me.